Thank you very much. Thank you, Professor Mayer, for that overly generous introduction. And thank you, Dean Daly, for the tireless advocating of better quality facilities, the tools to expand student filmmaking into new platforms and realms. We truly have you to thank for the tremendous growth that this school has experienced under your leadership. What it was when I left 20 years ago, what it is today is amazing. Round of applause for Dean Daly. I'm incredibly honored and humbled to accept this award today, and I'm thankful for the incredible opportunity to return to this university and share some, I promise, mercifully brief thoughts with you on this very special occasion. I will tell you one of the favorite things about being a film producer is that I get to spend 99% of my time behind the scenes, on the other side of the camera, on the other side of the curtain, away from the spotlight. Now, it's true that once a year, I travel to a magical place called Comic-Con, where I find myself standing in front of 8,000 people, but there, I can quickly lower the lights, I show them some clips of some of our movies, I bring out a few stars, and the spotlight quickly comes off of me. And today, no stars, no clips, you just got me. I'm very, very sorry. Chalk it up to the first of many disappointments in life ahead. I will admit that I've been a film nerd and a fanboy my entire life, and that I get to live in an age where that socially dysfunctional and slightly abnormal personality trait can lead to not just a successful career, but accolades and honors such as this today is nothing short of miraculous. There are many other points of history where I could have popped up and would not worked out as well for me. I promise you that. And I want to acknowledge and thank Mary Pickford and George Lucas and the countless pioneers in between for creating this extraordinary age that allows me to do what I love to do. All I ever wanted to do was make movies. I'm sure, I hope, that's true for many people in this room. It started before my obsession with Star Wars, before my obsession with Back to the Future. Growing up in Westfield, New Jersey, movies were my life. They were my fantasy, New Jersey. They were my fantasy, they were my escape. But USC became a real dream for me, something palpable that I could set my sights on. And I started plotting my course here in 1985 when I was 12 years old and learned that George Lucas and Robert Zemeckis and Ron Howard and Bob Gale and Joe Johnston all attended the same school, which I couldn't believe that there was this one school on the other side of the country. And I wanted to learn in those hallways with their equipment, with their teachers, walk those same grounds. And in 1990, at the start of my senior year in high school, and against the very good advice of my guidance counselor, I applied to one school and one school only. And thankfully, I was accepted. I was accepted into USC in that fall. I made the trip across country and was very excited. There's only one problem. I had been accepted to the broader university. I had been rejected by the film school. So I started taking courses, required courses for the bachelor's degree. And come spring, I applied again to the film school, and I was rejected again. I applied again the next fall, and I was rejected. But the spring after that, I was rejected. And it wasn't until the following fall where I was rejected again. That's five times, if you're keeping score. My friends and my family started to politely suggest that maybe I look for another major. They said USC was actually a very large university with a number of wonderful areas of academic study outside of film. I told them I had no idea what they were talking about. These were the same people that told me that USC was famous for sporting clubs of some kind or social fraternities or something, and I had seen no evidence of that in my 2 years at the school thus far. I had seen the film school, I had seen the inside of Norris Theater, and that was it. So I decided to apply just one more time. For some reason, I thought six rejections would look better on a resume than five, but I would only ever get the five, because that spring, I was finally accepted into the place I've been dreaming about. Let's hear it from me 20 years ago. Thank you. I was finally accepted into that place. And I will tell you, in the 20 years since then, I've been very, very lucky. I've experienced a number of wonderful things. I've gotten married. I have two kids. I've been able to work with numerous amazing types of people. I've produced two of the top five films of all time. But I swear to you, getting that envelope with the acceptance to this school still ranks right up there with all of those. If there are any of you today that was accepted the first time you applied, I feel a little sorry for you. I do. Because rejection is a common occurrence in the film industry. Learning that early and often will help you build up the tolerance and the resistance. Hopefully, it makes it easier to keep going and keep trying. And now, here I am with all of you today. The school's more rigorous than when I was here, the competition more fierce. I'm told that this class is one of the best and brightest and most creative classes in recent history. I don't know if that's true or not. It is true. Okay, good. I am impressed. You should be proud. Congratulations to all of you. You deserve it. However, that hard-earned and impressive USC diploma is not a golden ticket to success. It could be a golden ticket to one of the many mafia members taking your call, getting an interview, replying to an email, but that's it. And I will tell you that since graduating, as I've said, I've produced some very big movies. I've seen and spoken with some very powerful and famous people. I've gotten to know people I looked up to as I was a kid. I have met and I have made movie stars. But I have also picked up hundreds of people's lunch orders. I've washed dozens of cars. I've walked other people's dogs. I've chauffeured people. I've chauffeured people's dogs. I've gathered up people's dry cleaning, spent thousands of hours making copies, answering phones. But I will tell you, I did all those things the very, very best I could. I didn't look down on any of those things because I learned early on that if you can't wash a car, or walk a dog, or pick up lunch, or deliver a package, or heat up some soup, you aren't ever going to be asked to do much else. Nobody will ever help you achieve your dreams unless you can do the seemingly simple and easy tasks first, no matter what the diploma says. Nobody's going to hand you your dreams. You need to earn them by making people trust you enough to help you achieve them. Nobody wants to waste time on someone who can't handle having their dreams come true. So start doing the little things well, because they lead to very big things. I'm especially excited to be here today because in 1995, I did not walk with my class. I graduated in December of 95. The ceremony didn't happen until the summer of 96, by which point I was already doing some of the things I just mentioned as an assistant to a producer, and I didn't have time. I had to work. That is Hollywood. There's nothing more urgent or more personal than filmmaking. It takes up a lot of time, but it makes it all the more poignant to be standing here for the first time today with all of you in this cap and gown. It really does mean a lot. You will hear, you have heard a million lessons about how to dream, where to dream, who to dream with. The only thing that matters, of course, is that you do dream. Let nothing get in the way. Work on good movies, work on great movies, work on crappy movies. Learn the business. Stand behind or even in front of the camera. But remember that something somewhere drew you here to this place, and you owe it to yourself to keep pursuing that dream. I want to thank all the guests today, the faculty, all of you parents. It's a privilege to be here with Jim Giannopoulos, a man I respect very, very much. And most importantly, congratulations and good luck to the class of 2014. Thank you very much. Thank you.